Oh, your love is strong. chose me first. You chose me first. You chose me first. You loved me first. Thank you.
Love.
There is no one else.
Yeah, we thank you, Lord, that you chase after us, God, that you come after us with such pride and such love and such dedication to us, God. And Lord, we thank you, God, just for your presence, God, that it's not dependent on how well we do, God, on what we can do for you, God, but it's just because you love us. It's just because you love us, God, that love is so reckless for us, God. It does anything for us, God. And I'm so thankful. We're so thankful. Yes, God. Thank you, God. Tonight we will be praying for the church in North Korea. And as I lead out in prayer, come into agreement with me, and afterwards, please lift up your own intercession to the Lord. Yeah, just remember all of what you feel right now, that relentless love, and I just ask God that you pray it into North Korea. Lord, make known, make evident the pursuit of your unrelenting love for your children in North Korea, for the North Korean church. Lord, we ask, oh God, that you would just speak into their hearts, God, that they would declare, God, that your love is unrelenting towards them, God. Just spark a continual growth in them, God. And Lord, we just ask, oh God, that as you pursue them, God, as you pursue the North Koreans, God, that they would come under submission to you, God, to Jesus, wholeheartedly. And Lord, we declare that the North Korean church have greater revelation of a fierce love that leads to an assurance of God's presence. And God, we ask that you reveal yourself as the love that triumphs, it trumps every fear. And the enemy cannot say a word. Lord, we just declare that this fear is conquered by love. And nothing can separate the one God loves from himself. And we speak this right now over the North Korean church. Let us pray.
Thank you.
Yeah, Lord, you have dominion over every living creature and place. Lord, your sovereignty has no limits, and it covers North Korea. Your faithfulness to North Korea is endless, and you are good. Your plans are good. And you have not abandoned nor forsaken the North Korean church. So we proclaim tonight, God, that you see them and that they cannot be separated from your goodness. You have attached them to yourself, and you are Jehovah Nissi, one who is a sure fire banner for the North Korean church. And you are the Lion of Judah, powerful in battle. You cannot be overtaken. You are always accurate in every battle. You make no mistakes. You are not intimidated by the enemy's moves. You have every counterattack for every attack of the enemy. And your provision and protection you provide for the North Korean church, it cannot be matched or overruled, and it is more than enough. Let us pray. Lord, we ask for you to continue to shift the atmosphere toward reconciliation. Lead the North Korean church, the leaders, the citizens, and their South Korean counterparts into reconciliation, facilitated by the Holy Spirit. Continue to stir up the momentum of reunification. Lord, use the Olympics, presidents, leaders, or any circumstance. Lord, whatever you desire to use in order to push forward an exponential increase in optimism and hope for reunification, we just come into agreement with it right now. And Lord, we know that you will provide more opportunities for ministerial talks within the government, leaders of North Korea and South Korea. Lord, we ask that you don't allow the North Korean church or the South Korean church to be caught in unpreparedness. Lord, as you begin to move, we just ask that you ready their hearts emotionally and ready them for the cultural, political, and other factors necessary for a healthy reconciliation. We release your grace for the future transitions into a healthy and whole One Korea. Let us pray. Oh God, that you would align the heart, mind, and spirit of the North Korean church to yours so as to see with the eyes of the Lord. And we declare that they have vision to see One Korea as you do, Lord. Let them see it in the spirit so that they can rejoice with greater joy when it is revealed in the natural. And we prophesy boldness to declare it as done. Lord, let them be unafraid to speak out your victory with wisdom, but without fear of looking foolish or being punished. And we declare, God, that they would reject the fear of being wrong and wait in expectation for you to finish what you've begun. As they wait, may they have grace and perseverance to withstand and not grow fatigued, but instead grow in assurance and faith that you are faithful, God. Lord, seal up this assurance, and as you do, may they offer praise and thanksgiving and begin to grow an ever joyful heart, God. And we just pray these things in your name. Let us pray. Yes, Lord. We just declare that you, Father, the very creator, the essence of love, you are a good father. And your love is relentless, God, in your pursuit for the North Korean church. And this pursuit, Lord, we declare will lead them to submission, into submission, and in confidence they will declare, just that you are good and be unashamed. And Lord, we just declare, God, that there's a growing confidence in them, God, to declare you as their surefire banner, God, that you are victorious, God, and that you are sovereign, God. And Lord, that you have jurisdiction, and Lord, that you have the legal authority, that nothing can override your authority, God. And so, Lord, we just come into agreement with your heart for our One Korea, and to declare that you will move and shift preparations necessary for reconciliation. And as you do so, God, we just declare victory and thanksgiving for just knowing that you are good, God. We prophesy that over the North Korean church, that they too will have a heart of victory and thanksgiving, God, offering praise because you are victorious, you are steadfast, and you are faithful. Yeah. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.